Welcome to the December edition of Rumours and Lies. Battlefront officially announced Flames of War version 4 on their website earlier this month. There has been a strong campaign on third-party sites, but this is the first official announcement of version 4 via the company's own communication channels. As well as announcing the March release date for version 4, designer Phil Yates posted 10 points about changes in the new version of Flames of War. I'm not going to recap them here. You can read them on Battlefront's Flames of War website. I was tempted to try and summarise the version 4 discussion here, but there's just too much detail and discussion for me to meaningly cover. Rumours and Lies is primarily about new releases, so I'll concentrate on those. If you want to follow the discussion, check out Battlefront's own forums, the What Would Patton Do version 4 forums, and the various Facebook groups for Flames of War. I'll post these links in the description below. Battlefront also posted details of some of the upcoming version 4 books and miniatures. Existing players will receive a free copy of the 108-page rulebook covering early and late war, as well as a 64-page book covering special rules and warriors. These books cover the version 4 rules, along with conversions for existing version 3 forces lists. The redemption process outlined on the website has players showing their version 3 rulebook at their local game store and receiving a sticker which entitles them to the new books. How the sticker is exchanged for the books is not outlined on the site. This will be a bit unwieldy for players like me who are hundreds of kilometres from their nearest store, but hopefully there will be more details closer to the release date. Mid-War players will have to buy the new Flames of War 4th edition book, a hardcover 120-page rulebook covering the version 4 rules for that period. This is the full new version 4 book and will introduce features like vehicle cards. There will be some very minor differences from the rules in the early Late War version 4 book, but the overall mechanics will be essentially the same. The initial focus here is on mid-war, and specifically North Africa. This will leave some mid-war players like Americans and Russians without lists to use at this stage, until new version 4 compatible lists are released. To get new players started, Battlefront will release the LLMain box set. This new starter set contains one version 4 mini rulebook, one Panzer IV, one Panzer III, one Grant, and two Crusaders. Interestingly, no infantry or guns, which makes this closer to a Flames version of the tank skirmish game. In keeping with the North African theme, the Desert Rats hardcover army book will be released. This covers British forces in North Africa in 1942 and 1943. It has a companion box set, Monty's Desert Rats, which contains one mini rulebook, five Grant tanks, three Crusaders, and two 17-25-pounder guns. These are all in plastic. The inclusion of the 17-25-pounder is interesting. The 17-pounder was not a common weapon in the desert. This weapon was essentially a prototype. In 1943, the 17-pounder gun was in development, but a new carriage hadn't yet been finalised. 100 pre-production guns were mated to the existing 25-pounder carriage and sent to the desert to counter the threat posed by the new Tiger tanks. It proved very effective. The M3s in the box set are listed as Grants, but we don't have any details yet on whether the plastic kit allows long and short 75mm guns, or includes both the Lee and Grant turrets. The Crusaders look like Mark III's, armed with the 6-pounder gun. The Germans also get a new version 4 book. The Afrika Korps hardcover book covers German forces in the desert in the 1942-43 period. The companion box set, Rommel's Afrika Korps, has a mini rulebook, three Panzer IVs, five Panzer IIIs, and two 8.8cm flak 36 guns. Again, these are all new plastic kits. The 8.8cm gun played a significant role in the desert campaign. The Germans used this weapon's great range over the flat desert terrain, causing casualties before the British tanks could close to effective range for their own less powerful guns. I'm looking forward to seeing the plastic kits for these guns. Again, we don't have any firm details of the versions of the tanks or the options and variants, but the Panzer IVs look like F2s with the globular muzzle brake. The Panzer IIIs appear to be 5cm armed versions. Note that some have the earlier mantlet, while some have the added spaced armour mantlet I think is characteristic of the L series, but don't quote me on that. So those are the Flames of War books, kits and box sets that were announced this month. Team Yankee had some new releases announced. Probably the biggest announcement is the East Germans. Pre-orders for this release are slated for January and include the Volksarmee book, a resin and metal T-55 AM2 Panzer Company box, as well as East German infantry. Resin and metal BRDM scout cars for Eastern Bloc forces are also on the release schedule. British forces have also expanded with a plastic Scorpion Scimitar box set. These are fast, lightly armoured reconnaissance vehicles. The Scorpion is armed with a 76mm gun, while the Scimitar fields a 30mm Raden cannon. The box set contains four vehicles with optional parts to build either version. These are a favourite of mine, so I wouldn't be surprised to end up with at least one box of these. Something to look forward to in 2017. Team Yankee also now has special order support weapons. This allows you to order additional individual support weapons teams like anti-aircraft missiles, anti-tank missiles and other support options for your Team Yankee forces. The special order page on the Team Yankee website gives links to order these from the Battlefront online store. The Plastic Soldier Company has some new releases, including these 15mm Canadian military pattern 1500 weight trucks. Not as exciting as a King Tiger, but these are a workhorse for British units. My box set of these arrived this week, so look for a build or inbox review of these soon. But the really exciting news is the announcement that the long-awaited 15mm Universal Carriers are due for release. There's no firm release date yet, but the carriers will be 5 in a box and can be made into at least 7 different variants. As well as the standard transport version, the options include an MG carrier, mortar carrier, ammunition carrier, OP, and 2 different flamethrower versions. The carriers pictured appear to be Mark IIs, but there's no information if these can be built as Mark I's. Given Battlefront is also releasing a plastic carrier, it'll be interesting to compare these when they come out. The very last thing I want to touch on in this episode is our good friends from Dice of War. Adam recently announced a product I didn't even know I needed, a card wallet for holding unit cards for Team Yankee and Flames of War. The card wallets have a number of plastic sleeves to keep your unit and formation cards safe and undamaged, and come with a national sticker on the front. I can see these being strong sellers as unit cards become more widely used. In new dice releases, Dice of War will be releasing East German DDR dice as well as generic Soviet dice. The German dice are good timing given the upcoming release of East German forces for Team Yankee. So that's December's roundup of announcements and product releases. Thanks for watching, and thanks for those people who've taken the time to like and subscribe to Fog of War since I started this channel in April. I hope I can keep producing entertaining and informative Flames of War and related content in 2017. So Merry Christmas and Happy New Year from me. I hope Santa brings you lots of gaming products, but if he doesn't, at least there are some exciting new products due in 2017.